Well, as we've been reporting, there were fresh arrests in the National Insider Trading Probe, including this man, James Fleischman. You're looking at some exclusive video. We have some exclusive video of him. There he is, returning home from a California court. The charges, though, originate here in Manhattan at the Southern District Court, and that is where my next guest spent 6 years as an assistant U.S. attorney. He's Christopher Clark, now a partner and head of the white-collar crime defense practice at Dewey and LaBeouf. Thank you so much, Chris, for joining us. And what do you make of these new developments?
I mean, it's a pretty big development. You have a case that there was one arrest made, and now in one fell swoop, there are five more people in custody. There's another cooperating witness who's been identified. And there are allegations in the arrest instrument, the complaint that was filed yesterday, that these arrestees had conversations with other people at hedge funds about information that, you know, certainly sounds like it was proprietary to their employers.
On the face of it, sounds like.
Yeah, and shouldn't have been released. So, you know, it's a pretty substantial development in this case.
So do you think that the next people targeted would be those in hedge funds?
You know, it would be a logical inference to say that the next people they'd look at are the people these defendants allegedly had conversations with. Mm. It would make sense.
It would. What do you make of this Daniel DeVore, who, as you had referred to, is the cooperating witness, I suppose you would call him, in this investigation? What do you think he has done so far or is doing with the investigators?
It's really hard to say, but, you know, having unsealed something as opposed to just unveiling him, you could speculate that he was doing something for a while and the government preferred to not have anyone know he was doing it. Well, what do you usually do when you're doing that? You're either taping people or you're gathering evidence that otherwise you think would disappear. So it's quite possible that he was out there having these kinds of conversations and trying to get him on tape or get documents about him, etc. Speculation, but somewhat informed speculation.
Right, informed, certainly, from your experience.
Yeah.
Those arrested, though, what's the likelihood of the time that they'll spend in jail? You know, where are they going to go from here?
It depends entirely on a bunch of different factors. I mean, first of all, it's quite possible some of them will cooperate. I mean, just because the government has the proof of their conversations, it doesn't mean they may not want more proof. They may not want an actual witness to it. Mm. That would significantly, you know, diminish their exposure to jail time.
Basically trading off information for jail time.
Precisely.
Then. Okay.
The amount at stake, I mean, it's impossible to know right now because we don't know the other side of this, how much anybody made in profits from this information. And that's really a big driver of your sentence. So it could range from anywhere to, you know, a year or two too many years.
Mm. I've read some reports up to 20 years.
20 years would be, you know, a sentence for someone who made many, many millions of dollars in insider trading. Many millions of dollars.
This is being driven out mostly here in New York in many sense, but give me the sense of the national network that's going on.
Well, I mean, look, you can have an investigation that's being run in New York, but obviously, I mean, we've seen press reports about a guy in Portland, two agents drive up to his house. Obviously, this gentleman was arrested in San Francisco today. In today's world, you know, especially when it comes to technology, you know, there's a web that goes across the United States, and so do the agencies that look at it. And so there's an SEC regional office in California. Frankly, I think the criminal prosecution is here, but they'll get the assistance of the FBI across the United States.
All right, Chris, thank you so much for shedding that light for
My
us.
Pleasure.
Chris Clark of LaBeouf, Dewey and LaBeouf, the law firm.